Yo, what up everyone, this is Dr Duda from the Casa, the producer. So this is how I produced the track Nana. This is the fun game, the fun part of everything after I've just produced and arranged everything. It's the mixing part of music, you know. So I would normally do the EQs, do compressors, reverbs, you know, and all the side chaining and stuff. I start with the drums and the music only, you know. So remember, sometimes within the music there's a certain sound that you want it to stand out and be the kind of like melody that holds the song from start to finish, you know. So in this case with Nana, it was just chords, you know, so I had to EQ the chords so that they can get more shine than every sound that's there. And then obviously the bass line I had to like position it to a certain frequency that everyone hears the bass, whether you're using a small radio or headphones like that, you can just hear the bass all over, you know. So this is how I would do it. And then obviously with vocals, I'll just put more EQs, reverb, just to get a certain sound. There's a certain sound that I always love. I can't even explain it, but it's more crystal clear, you know, and more brighter than, you know. So I would choose a different EQ on the lead vocal, different EQ on the backing vocals, and then choose more like another different one on the chorus and stuff, because when someone is listening to a song, they need to hear whether, okay, this is a lead vocal and then there's backing vocals which are like much warm and softer, and then there's chorus, and then chorus, you need to hear that boom, here's the chorus, now everything sounds fat, you know. So whereas the lead vocal should match with the music and stuff. So it can be loud, it can be, you know, but needs to sit at a certain frequency level so that someone can hear what you're saying, you know, as a singer. So I would normally choose the EQ just to fit every instrument, you know, because some of the instruments, they kind of like share the same frequency. So you need to shape the EQ in a way that everything just fits into that frequency, but smoothly, you know. Okay, let me give you an example. So when playing Rhodes, I know Rhodes, they kind of like have that bassy sound in it. So if I just want to kill that frequency by like minus 14 dBs, so that it gives space, especially for a pad or a bass that's gonna, you know, join in. So, let me see. Yeah. So you'll hear when the bass line comes in that it has more, you know, room to. Brass section. But normally play around with the EQ on the brass so that I get the same color that I want in terms of sound, not too bright and not too, you know, on the low end, just in the middle, you know, just shape, cut out the highs and then shape. So maybe shape the mid range a little bit just to put it high so that obviously it sounds like a brass, you know. So the frequency is already it's already there. If even if you're playing it alone, the brass will just, you know, fit perfectly on the music. Obviously when everything is playing together and the bass line, let me just play all the music and then without the vocals.
Let's go back where we started. Let's go
back. So the mixing of the vocals, there's one rule that I always use, which is my rule. The compressor, the EQ and delay, and a reverb, obviously. So how I would normally start, I'll start by tuning the vocals and make sure all the vocals are in like key, because a singer is only human. Sometimes they get a little bit flat on some notes, you know, and sometimes they hit it nice. But most of the time you need to just get in, like get deep into that vocal channel line and see the actual wave and see whether they're hitting the right notes. I'm using Cubase, you know, so Cubase makes it easier for me. I just get into that pitch and warp. Pitch and warp shows you all the notes that are in the singer is actually hitting. So if you're a keyboard player, you can actually see whether this note is wrong or is hitting the right note. So I'd normally play maybe a chord. So the song is on A flat, which means your F is your minor. F flat is A flat minor, yeah. So I'd look at the scale on the A flat minor and then listen to the vocal, how it goes.
How do I how do I say,
see, this is the problem.
How do I say, how do I say something?
And I'll just fix this one and then listen to the other ones. So you can hear when you move. So you can actually change the melody if you just wanna, you know, have fun with it. Just do this.
How do I say sorry?
Or you can just change it to
how do I say sorry?
So this is the fun part that I always enjoy. And then now you need to go, like you need to listen to each and every lyric that is in there or recorded sound when it comes to vocal and tune. It takes time and you just need to be patient and tune the whole song. You
know? When I know I'll let you down, when I know that I was wrong.
See, you can change this one if you want. When I know that I was wrong.
Oh, 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 oh.
Check.
I was wrong. Tell. When I know I let you down. When I know that I was wrong. Tell me how. When I know I let you down. When I know that I was wrong.
So this is how I tune vocals by vocals, including chorus. Anything that has vocals in it, I just tune everything. Unless there's no, it's not singing. Maybe it's he's talking somewhere, and then obviously I won't tune that, you know, trying to you have to make it as, you know, original as possible so that you can be able to perform this thing live, you know. So you can hear I've tuned them, but there's no like auto tune in them, you know. So with auto tune they can sound like, they're gonna sound like this.
How do I say sorry? when I know I let you down, when I know that I was wrong.
So, but now when performing live, people need to, they're expecting to hear the same, you know, recorded sound from the song. So you try as much as possible to keep it more live. Everything is in tune, but I didn't put that auto-tune effect. I was just correcting the pitch within his voice, you know. So, and then I would insert an EQ, and I would obviously do, but obviously put on a thingy, compressor. So why I'm putting compressors, because when singing, sometimes the voice becomes loud, and sometimes it becomes softer, or sometimes they just hit it more louder, you know. So as a listener, you mustn't pick that up, you know. So I'll just put a compressor with the limiter, so that if he sings above maybe zero, or, you know, it just, you know, drags him there. It doesn't like allow him to go over, and then the sound becomes now much more smoother, you know. So when he's too low, obviously there's a certain room that I'll just, you know, put the threshold, so that everything becomes smoother. When he's softer, you can still hear the vocals clear, and when he's louder, you can still hear the vocals clear as well, you know. So that's why it's important to put compressors and stuff, you know. So when it comes to delay and reverbs, that's the most important part, obviously. The main issue about this is do not insert your reverb or your delay, you know. By inserting that, you're losing the actual recorded audio, you know, and then it's gonna get affected by your reverb or delay, and then nothing will run smoother. So you send your reverb and your delay, because by sending, it means now the original recorded audio is still there, and then the effect, and then just adds, you know, after, you know. Because when you insert your plugin, and then it loses that quality, of course. So when you send the reverb and stuff, you still have your normal wave line, and then it has those reverb and delay at the back, I would say, and then everything becomes smoother, because you're still playing the original sound but sending, you know. And then by doing that, you can able to measure your level of how do you want your reverb or delay, you know. Is it?
Give me. When I know I let you down, when I know that I was wrong, tell me, how do I? Sure, you're tired of the same old story.
This is how it would sound if they
but
tried.
I need you around, wouldn't be the same without you, I promise.
And this is how it would sound with three.
You, I know what I'm asking might be too much to take. I'm not one for begging, but when it comes to you, things change.
And then when it comes to a chorus, the EQ is now, it has to be different, you know. It mustn't sound as bright as the lead, because obviously there's like more than one or three, four, five vocals in chorus.
How do I say let's go back where
give me
I when I'm not begging, but when it comes to you, things change. Won't you please forgive
me? I when I'm not, nana, would you please forgive me? I when I'm not, nana,
Would you please forgive me? Away, Nana, Nana, would you please forgive me?
So on chorus, your reverb, it's, I normally use like slightly, not too much, not because remember on chorus there's too many things happening, and so you mustn't like put your reverb that it will fill everything in the song, and then something becomes, you know, otherwise the song will come, like as far as mixing is concerned. So I'd normally put chorus vocals as dry as possible, but just EQ, you know, and add the delay if it's needed, you know.
Awe Nana, Nana, would you please forgive me?
So I just put like a small reverb, you know, in it, and then obviously everything that has vocals, I mean, I do put compressor on all of it so that nothing gets above a certain level that I've, you know, made. So if it's something below zero, it's something below zero. It's not vocals, they won't hit something above, you know. So I always put compressor, you know. So some they record with the compressor. I still record with the compressor, but when mixing, I make sure I still put compressor in them. So yeah, that's how, you know, I normally do or complete a song, you know. And then one thing for sure, I don't do mastering. I just do mixing only and then send it to mastering, you know. The reason why I don't do mastering is because when making a track, especially mixing and arranging, already your ear is tired. So by mastering it, you're gonna like almost doing the same thing. You wouldn't hear the song if it's mixed or mastered, you know, because your ear gets tired of the same thing, listening to a song time and again, you know, more than 1,000 times, you know. So I'd rather send it to someone to go master it for me, because they've got fresh ear now, you know, so the approach won't be the same. Yeah, but this is how this is how it came about, to like when Mikasa is doing a song, you know. So